What is SuperEdge? SuperEdge is made by Renesas Technology Corp. This corporation is in Japan. This CPU is MSC CPU. This CPU used well in Japan and Europe and North America. SuperEdge have many kind of CPU, SH1, SH2, SH3, SH4, and others. This CPU is a 32-bit CPU, and SH64 is a 64-bit CPU. This CPU is used for NAS, cellular phone, and LCD TV controller, and PC. Of course, NUX is working. I'm porting Debian of SuperEdge now, but before I porting, starting porting,
that's a crazy word.
Have two time porting. Event. First, SuperEdge porting event is Yankee port in Japan, 1999. Yankee port to Debian with Mr. Yagashi and Mr. Ishikawa and Mr. Furuza. Three people is Debian developer. This project is support this project is SS3 and SS4 support. But development step in 2005, second SuperEdge porting. This second SuperEdge porting is an iHack project. iHack project is iHack project target is RAM disk and RAM tank. RAM disk and RAM tank have a SuperEdge for CPU. This porting for by this device, the book of the future of a lot of RAM disk runtimes were made. This device has many software, but Debian package is very old, and users cannot provide the key for this project. Lantern and RAM disk device is the CPU is SH7651R. This CPU is 2066 MHz and 64 MB RAM and RouterDMM1333P88 and 100S network and USB 2.0. This is NAS NAS. Two times porting is dead. But I want to porting to SH of Debian. Because I'm Debian user and in new maintenance process. And I want the distribution to which SH is supported. Then it's supported in experimental, but I don't want to use Gen3. And I want to enable the user of SuperEdge to use Debian. improvements aspect on Debian project. I think Debian users of every member. We can approach the conquest of the competency architecture, I think. And I think from aspect from super IT user and developer. Now, super IT user and developer don't have officially support distribution of super IT. If Debian support super IT, I think they become easy to develop stuff. Development super IT and the development start to easy, I think. I'm porting to porting to Debian super IT. I have some problem. First, I want to support architecture in Debian. SuperH has main CPU, but I think target is SH4 only, and I plan to support the virtual Debian first. SuperH is SuperH have two Debian, virtual Debian and big Debian. Many device have many device use virtual Debian only. I think I plan to support the virtual Debian first. Second, I think don't build SuperH binary package. However, there is a not following problem. First, about FPU. SH3 don't have FPU process FPU. And about calling convention issue. SH3 and SH4's ABI is different. But calling ABI's recap point is 1. About cache issue, SH3's assembly and SH4's assembly assembly code is cache code is different. If
that would be a kernel issue, not user space.
Yeah, user space.
The user space doesn't need to touch the caches. The kernel, only the kernel touches the caches at all.
Yeah.
You can write your code so that it takes advantage of the cache.
Sure, but that shouldn't be a difference in the user space.
If you use SH4 binary on SH machine, we have three problems. But
you get the troubling codes where you write to the stack address and jump to it.
Mm-hmm.
Java and other stuff too.
Yeah.
These produce cache problems in user land.
Okay. I thought we were trying to get rid of turbulence.
Yeah, but they insist.
Okay.
I checked troubling code use program. Troubling use program is Java and Java only, I think.
There's a GCC extension that allows defining functions inside other functions that, and the inner function can access the variables of the outer function that also uses champions.
Yeah.
I think no one uses that.
Someone does.
But it's still the end. I thought it depends the way it produces it.
First problem and second problem is fixed by kernel process, kernel fix. But the third problem is fixing now. When the result it is possible to work in SS3 by the SS4 version, I think. And Big Engine support. I plan to support the Big Engine after Little Engine. SH CPU have Ethernet device to chip. SH3 have Ethernet device. Ethernet device is a big area. My plan is first, Little Indian support, second, big area support. I start this project last year in August. Now status is discussion in mailing list and SH4 binding support only. Build essentials package is built now. Local build reworking now. And SH4 dev bootstrap is working. And some package built about 2,000 package. This is my development machine. I use Lantern, 3 Lantern, and RTS C7751R2B. This device present from Research Technology for me. This device is SS7751R and 64 megabyte RAM and 4 megabyte flash and shell slot and 100 base Ethernet and DSL bus and VGA control.
So is that that's an SH4?
Yes.
How do you know from the SS751? Do you know from that SH4? From Bangor, the decision.
Please give us it.
Okay.
It's like the arm. I think where is ARM 7, ARM 9, and ARM V4, ARM V5, ARM V3, and there's no real relation between them. Each CPU certainly has 3 or 4 of these attributes.
Okay.
Now the development team is on the iPad. That's a J.
Sounds a lot.
However, I have people who help development. Mr. Kenton, Kenton is the big area developer and supporting BigBigD. And Kei Kojima is being the super manager. And Kineko is tested my Debian package. And Potom is Debian developer. He's a GFC developer. But we want to and need some developer. I'm looking for the person for development. Yes. If interested in Superage, Debian for Superage development, I think I send development machine for you. I think.
Which libc are you using? Are you using new libc or usenfc or?
Other people use new libc. Use libc. I check embed Debian main list. I don't know this developer's name. He posted support UCDFC in every Debian. I'm interested to it.
But Paul uses GDFC now?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's just a full moment.
Okay. Yeah, because Ulrich Treppe always sounded not too excited about supporting too many architectures.
anyway, SuperH, as far as I'm concerned, is still among the main support architectures of GDFC. Unlike ARM.
Next. I think to do my to do is the official support architecture for Debian. It's fast. And restoration to debian.net. I have .NET, .NET, my local network. I want to restoration to debian.net. And create SSH porting and build the maintenance team. And send SSH Superage specific part to Debian package name. And now I send patch up to kernel Linux kernel headers and other. I send. And keep build the network. Now build the network is my local network. I want to speak IP address and keep the network. If how to get Superage device, you will be able to get in development with the following devices if you are interested in the development of Debian or Superage. First. Now we buy phone and Superage device. First, USS5P. This device is SS7751R and 64 megabyte RAM and shift slot and 100 US Ethernet and USB 2.0 port. PIPS. USB 2.0 port. This device cost is about $100. I have this device. Second, Airbox. Airbox is a router system. This device is CPU. This device CPU is SS775R, 551R, and 64 megabyte. Two 100 bases and one card bus slot. This device cost is about $5,000. Very expensive. this device will cheap, but this device name is SS7706 minor RAM. This device is SS3 device. And this device has 32 megabyte RAM and MMC slot and 100 base Ethernet. This device is cost. Device cost is about $17.
Does any of these have a JTAG port?
No. JTAG is no. But this this board has cheap firmware. We development Linux kernel. We use this small use firmware. But JTAG port is line only.
Okay, so I could, in theory, you could wire something out to have a JTAG port on the outside one.
I'm sorry.
So I could connect a JTAG somehow to this board.
Sorry, I don't know.
Yeah, that would be interesting for a development machine.
This device is DXEH16L. This device sell in Europe only. This device sell by Dexter. This device same LAN disk and LAN tag. So excuse me. This device cost is $300. If you are interested in this project, you get this link. Information from this link. Squatch's website and IRC and mailing list and wiki and my great Debian package repository and IOHacks website.
Are all these devices that you presented SH4 architecture or?
One of them was SH3.
Yes. Because, for example, at work I have a couple development boards with 7785, which is CH4A, which is fundamentally not very fundamentally, but incompatible in software level with SH4 cores. And I was wondering, did you think somehow about supporting this hardware also?
7785 is very new CPU. If you add a new SH4A use product we can not buy.
I don't think there are any products based on 7785 yet. It's just development boards.
So it's not really widely available, so it's a bit difficult for Debian to develop. Yes.
How do you bootstrap them? Do you boot on USB or do you have to flash it?
I use hard disk and
okay, so you write on the hard disk from another computer and just cross build everything, and then it boots on the device?
Yes.
It just runs, you can run Lilo on the compact flash, so you even put the kernel from the flash.
And what is this supposed to be, this device? What does it do? Does it have another operating system?
Well, it was originally running Debian.
Okay.
Okay. And it's supposed to be a USB hard disk hub. It's supposed to host multiple USB connected hard disk to the network as a network.
As a SAN or?
As a NAS. But we're not interested in the NAS part. We're just interested in the CPU for Debian port.
Yeah, okay. I was just curious about what it did.
So are you coping with 32-bit or 64-bit, or how are you dealing with the, I believe that there were 64-bit variant of Super H, is that correct?
Yeah.
Okay.
Would you need to go to the other one?
I use a 64-bit Super H is dead. and it is experimental CPU. I use 32-bit CPU only.
Okay.
It's like MIPS 64. It does exist, but few people saw it, right?
Yes, it was 64. Yeah, we are working to put it triage supporting GDPC and to change in Debian.
And you have hardware for that?
Most MIPS CPU are working. I mean, an India Cobalt is supporting 64-bit.
How many packages do you have working from Debian?
Now 2,000. Not for one. I check the 2,000 packages.
And you cross compile them?
No, native.
Natively? Using this hardware?
Yeah.
It only has 64 megabytes of memory, so that's the bottleneck.
Can you swap on USB? Well, that's what I do when natively compiling on time.
You can also swap over NFS.
The main development machine is a bit larger than this. It has an IE hard disk. So you can be swapping on hard disk.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you have two devices.
Yeah. Well, swapping on a USB hardware is not that slow.
Your community is currently building about 100 packages a day. How many packages a day is it building?
Say 17, around 17 to 19 packages.
Per days.
But if you use this device, for example, GCC compiling, I have 2 weeks.
Two weeks?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just one bucket.
So we can aspire to the one of the doorstop architecture.
But I have a secret device from a present from Renesas Technology secret development board. I development and compiling this device. This device have 128 megabytes RAM. It's very fast. This device is used 7785.
And does it run Linux? And it runs Linux?
That's its main development machine.
Of course it runs Linux.
Yeah.
Now I have your question. Is that SH4A?
Yeah.
Is it compatible?
Yes, SH4 and SH4A is compatible.
In a way, there is a number of problems concerning cache, for example.
No, I don't have problem about cache code.
So there's a difference between 4A and 4?
Oh, yes.
Was it much?
I think Unix is known to work.
Ah, yes, Unix, yes.
Mm. Which distributions, Linux distributions working?
Working on Gentoo. Gentoo is support is experimental.
Is the main list?
Main list?
Main list. Where can people join?
I think now local now member use local mailing list of development. I think a MOOC to Debian. Debian is the mailing list and development on the Debian is mailing list. And Debian is mailing list is free.
Is that English or Japanese?
I think same.
Same?
But,
it means mixed.
I think base language is English.
Ah, base language is English.
Can you switch back to the previous slide? Can you switch back to the list of websites, the URLs, the previous slide? I don't know. is, I think it's either a single little endian or big endian. Which one is yours?
Now we support the little endian only, but we have some support in Kenya. Indian device is I don't have a big Indian device. Little Indian device only.
I have a Dreamcast and it has a SH4. I just don't know if it has a little bit in the back, which one it needs.
Yes.
So,
Dreamcast is four.
Four.
Did you test your packages on some hardware from different vendors, not Renesas, but for example from STMicro?
Renesas Technology.
There are other vendors of SH4 platform like STMicro. Did you test that their hardware?
I tested on Renesas Technology only. I don't have STMicro device.
Is that very different? Are they very different?
Hopefully not.
It's SD, you never know.
Yeah. At least these guys contribute a lot to GCC, to GCC backend. Or should I say this guy? It's just one. One guy.
What kind of devices can you find them on?
Well, Siemens is supposed to produce a set-top box based on STMicro's 71 something, I don't remember. SH4 core.
Please help us and develop it with us.